Bee Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to take a look at Arduino voice control using the HC06 Bluetooth module. Light on. In this video, I'll show you how to connect your Bluetooth module to your Arduino, how to pair it to your cell phone properly so that you can use the voice app, and how to operate electronics using voice control. Let's begin. I want to start out telling you the items that I used in this video. I used male-to-male jumper wires, male-to-female jumper wires. I used a breadboard. I also used the Elegoo Mega 2560. Now you can use the Nano or the Uno as well, whichever you prefer. I used the HC06 Bluetooth module, and I used a USB to TTL converter. There are several out there, but I chose the FT232RL, and I chose it because, well, I had it. So you can use any of them. I also used three resistors. I used a 220 ohm resistor, I used a 1000 ohm resistor, and I used a 2000 ohm resistor. I used one LED just to make sure that it was working properly on my breadboard, and it was a 5mm LED. I used a 9-volt battery in the end for the final product, and I used a 5-volt relay module for the final product. So those are the items that I used in this video. This is the HC06 Bluetooth module. This module has a built-in 2.4 gigahertz antenna, and it also has an external 8 megabit flash. It's pretty small. It also has a small footprint at 27 by 13 by 2 millimeter, and it's also a 4-pin module as well, and let's take a look at those pins. And if you flip it over to the back, you can see that it is a 4-pin module. These top two pins here are the receiving and transmitting pins, and it's used for serial communication. It's the RX and TX pin. And the RX pin is a level 3.3 volt pin. Then you got your TX pin, the ground pin, and the VCC pin. And the VCC pin will operate at 3.6 volts to 6 volts. The first thing I'm going to do with my Bluetooth module is connect it to the USB to TTL converter and show you how to set that up. This is a look at the converter, the front and the back. The USB cable that you'll need to connect this to your computer is a Type A to a Type B Mini. The Type B Mini will plug into your converter. And over on the left, you'll see that I labeled the four pins that we'll be using, the RX, TX, VCC, and ground. Here I've got the converter connected to the Bluetooth module. You'll notice on the RX pin there's a voltage divider with two resistors, a 1000 ohm and 2000 ohm resistor. I'll show you a diagram how to set that up. Here is a little diagram. Hopefully it's helpful to see the connection. You'll see that there are two resistors making up my voltage divider. There's a 1000 ohm resistor connected to the RX pin of the Bluetooth, and a 2000 ohm resistor connected to ground. You'll see that each pin is color coded. You'll see that the purple line says RX to TX. The RX pin of the Bluetooth is connected to the TX pin of the converter. And then likewise for the other lines, you'll see TX to RX, VCC to VCC, and ground to ground. Okay, before we download the Android app, I want to go ahead and show you how to change any of the default settings on the Bluetooth module and set that up. So we're going to go from here over to our the Arduino IDE, and you can do this using the serial monitor. And the first thing you want to do is go up to Tools, come down here to select the correct port. For me, it's COM5. If it's not working for you, that may be what you need to do. Then we'll come over here and open up the serial monitor. Now, the first thing that you want to type in here, just to make sure that you're connected, is AT. And it's got to be capitalized, and you should get an OK sign back from the serial monitor. Down here, you can see I'm at 9600 baud, and I've selected no line ending. And then the next thing we want to do is see what version we have. One mistake I made when I first got this was I was working off a spec sheet for version 1. That didn't work clearly. So you want to do AT plus version. And you type that in. Here you can see that I'm using version 3. The next thing I'm going to do is change the baud rate. I'm going to go from 9600 to, let's go to 4800. So we'll do AT plus BAUD, and then you want to type in the baud code for 4800, which is 3. Hit enter. Now you should get a reply back from the serial monitor that says OK 4800. Then you have to go down here and, of course, change it to 4800. And I'm just doing this to show you how to do it. The next thing I'm going to do is change the password to my Bluetooth module. So AT plus PIN. Then I'm going to select the four-digit number. Let's do 0022. Enter. OK, set PIN. All right. And then the next thing I want to do, maybe I want to change the name of my Bluetooth module. So I would type in AT plus name. And then I want to name it. So I'll just name it Wild Bill. Why not? I think that's kind of a funny name. OK, name. So now whenever I'm pairing my Bluetooth module using my cell phone, I'm going to see a signal that says Wild Bill. And I'll know that that's my Bluetooth module. Now, if you missed any of that, here is a list of all the commands that I used. And then I've included the baud rate code over on the right. So if you want to change back to 9600 baud rate, you would type in AT plus baud. Look at that code over there for 9600. It's 4. So it'd be AT plus baud 4. And let's go ahead and do that. AT plus baud 4. So that's the baud rate that I'll be using. So hopefully this list here will help clear up any questions you have about being able to change the default settings of your Bluetooth module. All right, the first thing I want to do is make sure that this all works properly before I hook it up to the lamp. So I connected the Bluetooth module to the Arduino microcontroller. Over here you'll see an LED. That's just to make sure that I can turn it on and off using my phone. And it's connected to a 220 ohm resistor, which is connected to the negative rail. I went ahead and connected the 5 volt pin and the ground pin to the ground and positive rail of my breadboard here. And as you can see over here, I've got my 1000 ohm resistor, my 2000 ohm resistor, and I've got the RX pin connected to pin 12, and pin 10 is connected to the TX pin. And then so that's our setup. But next thing we're going to do is go ahead and download the app on our cell phone or iPad or whatever you may have. All right, from here, I'm going to go to the Google Play Store. I'm going to come up here and type in Arduino Bluetooth, or Arduino Bluetooth Control. We'll do it as well. And we're going to download the Arduino Bluetooth Control right here with the little robot picture there. Click on Install. And we'll let that install. And it is done. So let's open it up. Now we don't have the microcontroller plugged in yet, so that's what we're going to do now. All right, I'm just going to connect it directly to the computer with the USB. Now it's flashing. So on our cell phone, we're going to open up our connections for Bluetooth. Click on Bluetooth. But we should see a Wild Bill pop up here, and that's my Bluetooth controller. There's Wild Bill right there. All right, we're going to click on that. It's pairing. The pin that I set it up with was 0022. Hit OK. And it should connect. Now we're going to go back to our app here. Tap the little circles up here at the top. And select your device. Wild Bill is what I named my Bluetooth. Connecting to Wild Bill. There we go. Now we're connected. Now connect on this little face over here. And click on the face and then come down to vocal commands, vocal command configuration, and for vocal command 1, vocal command, we're going to call it light on, hit OK. Data sent, for the light to come on, we're going to give it a 1. 1 means on. Now we're going to back up here and go to vocal command 2. Vocal command, we're going to call it light off. Okay. Data to send, we're going to say 0. So 1 is on, 0 is off. Back up here. Back up again and again. Now we're going to come down to voice control down here at the bottom. And we should be able to use our Bluetooth and light over here that's connected. Light on. and it's on. And then click it again, light off. All right. So now that we have our app and our Bluetooth paired with our phone and microcontroller, we're going to go ahead and connect this to a 5-volt relay and connect it to a lamp. You can connect it to many different things. It doesn't have to be a lamp, but I just chose a lamp because that's kind of my go-to. Here's a look at the code. You should already have the software serial library on your Arduino. Up here we declare pin 10 and 12 for Bluetooth. It's a TX and RX pin. And down here, pin 6 is our output, which is the LED or a lamp. And in the loop, you'll notice that the number 1 is LED on, and the 0 is LED off. The code for this is pretty short and sweet. All I've done here is add a relay with an extension cord attached to it so I can plug the lamp into it and plug that into the wall. I also connected the signal to the relay to the same pin that the LED is on. You don't have to keep the LED, but I just decided to. You should never keep your relay exposed like this. You can be electrocuted with high voltage. I usually put a junction box over top of the relay to prevent anybody from being able to touch it. If you want to see a video on how to prep your extension cord and set up your relay, I do have a video linked in the description below from a previous video, so go ahead and check that one out. Well, now it's time to go ahead and turn the lamp on and off using the Arduino Bluetooth control app that we just downloaded.
Light on. Oh, I gotta plug it in. Just a second. Take 2. Light on. Light off. There you go.
So this is the final diagram. At the top of the relay, you'll see the extension cord that I drew here. One side connected to lamp, the other connected to wall plug. The only lead that I cut there was a positive lead, and I fed those through the two ports at the top of the relay. At the bottom of the relay, you'll see the positive and the negative ports connected to the breadboard, and you'll see the signal, the red line, the signal port connected to the LED, and the LED connected to pin 6. On the microcontroller. If I didn't want to use an LED, I could just connect that signal pin from the relay directly to pin 6 on my Elegoo Mega.
Well, that's all I've got for today. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like it by clicking the thumbs up button. Subscribe to the channel, click the bell notification button so that you know when we post new videos, and I'll see you again very soon.